In this video, we'll take a look at InSight's navigational controls and find out how to work with InSight's views and displays. When you start InSight, you're presented with a control panel. Most configuration and operations are performed through this window. We can load sessions and data, create new items and processes, and open new views and windows. Most views are opened using the View menu. Let's take a peek at some of the data in the 3D view. Most of InSight's views have a similar structure. A navigation bar at the top of the window contains controls for view position and data to display. A crosshair indicates the current mouse location, and at the base of the window, an information bar details the current crosshair location. In InSight, most items are displayed or hidden by clicking on the green or yellow lights. In the 3D view, click on the lights to toggle the display of the different sections, inline, crossline, and time slice. Within the 3D view, the mouse controls are straightforward. Left click and drag to rotate the view. Right click and drag to slide or pan the view. Roll the mouse wheel forward and backward to zoom in or out. To reposition one of the displayed sections, hold the control key and click and drag the section. If you roll the mouse wheel while hovering over the inline or crossline fields, the corresponding section will reposition by the specified increment. You can also jump by single increments using the arrow keys on the keyboard. Finally, you can enter specific values directly in these fields. Changing the displayed volume is easy. Hover over the volume selector and scroll the mouse, or use the page up and page down keys. Our velocity volume is now displayed in the 3D view. All of the visible volumes in the session are listed in the selector. The order of the volumes in this list matches the order in the control panel. The page up and page down keys provide a great way to compare two volumes. Use these keys to quickly flip between two volumes. If you have multiple 3D surveys in the session, use the survey selector in the navigation bar to switch between them. InSight will present inline and crossline sections for each of the surveys. You can toggle the display of a specific survey using the traffic lights. Our seismic is neatly placed in the centre of the 3D view. Rotation in the 3D view is defined around an anchor point. It is useful to set the anchor point when you are working on a specific region. There are two buttons that set the anchor point. The first sets the centre of rotation and updates the view. The second, Set Anchor and Align, does the same, but also updates the view to be orthogonal to the selected section. Once again, left click rotates the display, right click pans and shifts, while the mouse wheel zooms in and out. If things aren't going to plan and you need a quick way out, click the Home button to reset the 3D view. Click on the green spanner to update the background color, display survey, or XY grids, or configure any of the other 3D specific display parameters. The vertical Z scale controls the vertical scale of the display. Increase the scale to amplify the height of subtle features in your data. You can restrict the working area of the 3D view with a probe. Only data inside the selected probe will be displayed, helping InSight fly through huge projects at top speed. Another useful tool is volume visualization. Again, a probe is used to select the region, which is presented as a solid 3D prism. You can edit and move the probe, and the results update on the fly. Wells can be turned off and on, or displayed as ribbons or as lathed shapes. Remember that default and individual well settings are adjusted in the Well tabs of the control panel. Sometimes it's easier to work with data by investigating it line by line. 3D volumes, we can do this in the inline crossline view. As with the 3D view, this window has a navigation bar along the top. The controls work in the same way as the 3D view. You can click, roll the mouse wheel while hovering, or use the arrow keys. It'll be moved based on the increment specified. Once again, the volume selector chooses the data to display. Windows are linked, so that selecting a volume here will also change it in other views. If you look in the Volumes tab of the control panel, you'll see that the display volume is highlighted in yellow. Views are also linked via the red navigation bars. These show where the intersecting views and sections are located. Drag them to reposition the corresponding view. For example, This line shows the position of the cross-line intersection. If you double-click in any section view, the navigation bars jump to that point and update the views accordingly. Double-click on this well, for example, and the inline and cross-line view will automatically update. Everything we've seen so far has been in the time domain. So if you have a velocity model available, InSight can easily switch between time and depth. Use the domain selector in the navigation bar to switch between two-way time, true vertical depth, and even flatten projections if those have been configured. The time depth conversion settings are updated in the control panel under the File menu. You can see here that I'm using an interval velocity model, but RMS, average velocity, and other formats are supported. Left-click and drag to pan and slide the view. This is true for almost all of InSight windows, except for the 3D window. There are a few different ways to zoom in InSight. The plus and minus keys on the keyboard will zoom the entire window in and out. In the section view, right-click and drag to zoom to a specific rectangular region. To do the same thing for a single dimension, right-click and drag in an axis. Roll the mouse wheel up and down to zoom the entire view in and out, or mouse wheel in an axis to zoom in just that dimension. By right-clicking in an axis, the zoom will adjust to fit the data in that dimension. If you right-click in the view, a menu will pop up containing the zoom to fit option. That will reset both dimensions. Detailed information about the current cursor location is available in the crosshair values window. The precise XY, inline across line, time and depth values are shown, as well as the precise amplitudes of all enabled volumes. If you have wells loaded, it will also include values from the nearest well and its selected curves. InSight also includes other views tailored to handle specific information. The map view displays horizons, amplitude extractions, and slices through your data. It includes many settings for displaying culture, coordinates, and surveys. You can draw annotations and arblines, as well as display faults and horizon contours. The 2D view shows volumes in regular CMP spacing. It contains navigation controls specific to working with 2D. Similarly, the arbline view displays arblines through your data. These can be defined in the map window. Finally, there are 2D and inline crossline views for presenting gathers and working with gather data. If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dougio.com. And remember, have fun with InSight!